guys, we are doing a shoot right now, but I just quickly want to show you this clever setup that I put together. I'm really proud of myself and I want you guys to also benefit from it. So what I have is I've built my own director's monitor. Before, I'm sure you guys noticed that when I'm shooting, I shoot tethered to my laptop, but now I'm shooting to an iPad. And the reason is this is more mobile. I feel like it's rather easier to manage, especially on set if you're going to be shooting for long days. But then again, it has its own internal battery. It doesn't have as much capacity as my laptop. And so I was looking for a battery solution. And this is where everything started from. The most important part of this is the small rig iPad cage. This allows you to clamp these arms onto the iPad for easy holding, so you're not touching the screen at every single point. But what I wanted to solve, or the major problem I wanted to solve, was my battery and data transfer issue, right? Because it has only one Type-C port, and if I use that for power, it means when I'm shooting photos, I don't have access to the port for photos. So what I did was attach this dongle that I use for my MacBook into the Type-C port of the iPad. Now, what this allows me to get is two extra ports, where there's one for data and then there's one for power. So for power, just in case this iPad runs out of juice, I have the small rig battery attached or clamped to the cage, and I can just direct power from that small rig battery straight into this dongle. I can always just have extra battery for those long days where you're shooting. At least you know that you have constant power every single time. Now for data, I'm also shooting with my R5, and I have this Type-C cable that I'm always using, right? So I can run that through the other port, which is for data, and then the other end goes into the camera. So when I'm shooting, it's gonna come straight into Capture One, and I can monitor the footage as I go. Another clever thing that I added is my tripod base. So I can put this on my tripod. If there's no one to hold it, or if the client probably is tired of holding this for long hours, I can just set this on the tripod. And because it's going to sit on the ball head of the tripod, you can angle this in any direction, and then you're still going to have like a nice view for what you're doing. I'm really happy about this rig that I put together. I'm going to link everything I use in the caption. You can check it out and let me know what you think about it. So if you have a better solution, let me know as well. But for now, this is working for me really well, and I just wanted you guys to know about it.